trip behind the scenes with future country rock blues kings and queens. Discover them first with Palm Bash TV. Palm Bash TV.
Hello there, it's Palm Bash TV time again. Thank you so much for joining us. We got another great interview coming up for you shortly. But before we begin, don't forget about that subscribe button and the bell below you there. And click both of those, and anytime a new episode comes your way, you'll be notified. And you can leave a comment on the comment section if you'd like. I hope and love to hear from you there. And we're on Facebook at facebook.com/Palm Bash TV. And you can comment the things you see there. You can follow us, send us an inbox. And we'd love to hear from you there as well. But we'd love to hear from you a good old-fashioned email as well. PaulMashTV, all one word, @gmail.com. And if you're a band or a solo artist and want to be on the show, send us an email. We'll show you how to do that. But we love fan mail as well. So if you're just simply a fan, send us an email. We'll get back to you. And all this will be recapped at the closing credits at the end of the show. So stay tuned for that. We have DJ Formula from Wilmington, Delaware with us in just a minute. I'm sure you will enjoy everything he has to say there, and we'll get to that in a second. But before we do, we have a new sponsor on our show. It's called Galtar. It's politically correct guitars for the women, and we're going to show you that commercial in right now, and we'll be right back.
Ready in five.
Nothing else seems to match up. Galtar, the musical apparel that fits any outfit.
Galtar, bringing heaven to earth,
one gal at a time. GaltarHeaven.com.
Okay, we're back, and with us from Wilmington, Delaware, we have DJ Formula with us today. Thanks for joining us, DJ Formula.
What's up? How you doing? All right.
No problem. I'm doing pretty good. Glad to have you here today. We had a couple of issues getting him on the show, but at least we're here now, so everything's
good to go.
So tell us a little bit about how you decided you wanted to become an artist or a DJ or whatever it is. I mean, we would love to... hear your story about how you decided that's what you wanted to do.
You know what's so funny, man? A lot of people never, ever ask me about the artist part of what I do, because I'm a businessman. You know, me owning, I own a streetball and basketball team, and then I own my own alcohol. People never ask about the artist, but they forget that that's where I started. I mean, I was an artist first, and I used to work with Busy Bone from Bone Thugs and Harmony, and I was a rapper for the longest time. I mean, I still spit, and I got my final studio album that's coming out in October. So it's ironic that people are starting to ask me more about the artist thing than the business thing. But when I first got started, I was about 17 years old, just like everybody else. You know what I mean? Spitting rhymes in school. I mean, and getting somebody who actually showed me how to create songs and create song patterns and how to do it the right way. 16 bars hook. And then I just kind of fell in love with it. So, you know, and doing it for about 3 or 4 years at that point, working with my hustler spirit, working at Tommy Boy, I got a chance to meet Busy Bone's manager, who heard all of our demo tapes. We would go in the studio like every week. We would get paid and spend half our check in the recording studio every week recording songs, thinking they were going to blow up the very next day. We all had double CDs and double worth of music. So we ended up working with Busy Bone. I got to work with a couple other artists back in the day, Cuckoo Cal, Devin the Dude, Keith Murray. Ironically, just had a run-in with him a couple days ago. So weird. So that's where the artist side of it started. Shortly after the artist side, and I got to see the dark side of the industry, I started focusing more on the business and, you know, becoming brand ambassadors and things like that, and, you know, creating my own foundation, I mean, to live. So that's kind of where it all started.
Oh, okay. Well, I'm glad you found happiness in what you're doing, and hopefully you'll be around for quite a while there.
Thank you very much.
What are some of the influences? I mean, I'm sure you got a lot of good popular mainstream artists that come to mind, but why don't you share a few of them for me?
As far as influence, I'm more influenced by older artists, such as like older artists. As far as hip hop, you know, I like Lord Finesse, very big Lord Finesse, Big Daddy Kane, Common, Jay-Z, of course. But the reason why those artists come to mind, because they were the first bosses in the industry. They were the first independent bosses to make their own money, cut their own checks, and be the, you know, the arrowhead for their own destiny to make things happen. So I'm big on that part, being able to control your own destiny and let somebody else control it for you. Because who can control your artistic vision if you're the one having the artistic vision? Very hard to, I mean, it's very hard for somebody else to control it. So with that being the case, those are artists that I love. Now, as far as artists who inspire me to be great, I love artists like Marvin Gaye and Sade and people like that. When you can't say there's enough, this person to be the next Luther or this person to be the next this, there'll never be another Marvin. There'll never be another Sade. I mean, nobody there's so I so our voices are so iconic, you can't imitate it.
Yeah, I know what you mean, and you mentioned Big Daddy Kane and Common. You know, but I mean, I remember back in the day when they first came out, and they were really good at what they do, and I can see that in your influences definitely.
Thank you.
And if anybody wants to download your music or buy your CDs or whatever, where would they go? Also, tell us where you're on social media.
Okay, social media. I am DJ. I'm at DJ Formula Live 975 on Instagram, Dewey Formula Jackson on Facebook. And if you want to search any of my music on YouTube, just type Platinum Family Radio. Now, with Platinum Family Radio, you're going to see my music. You're going to see my interviews because I'm also a radio personality. I think the one I'm most famous for, as far as the music, is being the host of the only college syndicated radio show in the country. Back in 2009, I started the Platinum Show, which is the only college syndicated radio show. I was literally on 46 American countries. I'm sorry, 46 American markets, and I was on 31 international markets, such as Macedonia, Zimbabwe, places like that. So I was literally having my hip hop show played and had artists' songs played in countries where they really barely understood English. So like that's one of the one of my biggest pats on the back. I try to say, you know, I'm very thankful to be able to be the first in line for that. So it must have been pretty hard because I haven't seen a second syndicated college radio show, so I must be doing my thing.
Are you on any streaming platform though, like app
Yes.
or anything?
Yes, you can if you go to SoundCloud, YouTube, SoundCloud, and you can just Google my name and whatever comes up. Because like I said, I don't do too much of the mainstream, like that DistroKid and all that. I haven't done all that yet, but this next album will be the album that comes out in October. That's going to be everywhere. You can be able to get that on Apple Music everywhere.
Okay, well, go to your favorite streaming site, get DJ Formula's stuff. I know he would really love you for that. And like you said, be sure to check out that new album once that comes out soon. And
Yep, it's called the album's called The Masterpiece. And the reason why I call it The Masterpiece simply is because it took 30 years to make. I mean, now I made music, I've done plenty of records, I've done plenty of features and everything, but this album right here is I'm putting it all on the line. It took 30 years to make. So that's why it's the masterpiece.
Okay, well, we'll be looking forward to that, and make sure you check them out on all social media as well, like you know you're on Facebook, Instagram, all that stuff.
Yes.
Okay, and check them out there, and we're getting ready to watch your music video in just a moment. It's called The Return. Really great song too. Tell us a story about that song if you want to, or the video.
The song is called The Return. It's I was a part of a group when I was with working with Busy Bone and Seven Sign. I was a part of a group called the Young Legends. It was me and my brother Dom One, and Dom One passed away about 5 years ago, and you know, it kind of left like a void as far as the music for me. But it was so strange how I was in the studio, actually in my recording studio. I have my own recording studio, when I was recording one of the young guys, and it was like he was playing these beats, and all of a sudden I just started writing, and it just came out of me. Just like whatever that was in me, it was coming out, and I said, you know what, this is the return. And I had to actually shorten it because it was like 100 bars. I just started just going in, then I had to slow it down and put a hook and all that stuff. So it was like I just had to get it out, and it was almost like therapy to get it out. So did that last year, and just to get that out, just to get the rust off me and all that. So we just had some fun with it, man. And when we did it, we grabbed our cameras and then we just said, let's go ahead and make a video. So, we have everything here from the 5K cameras to the production. Plus, I told you I have my own recording studio here, so I can do everything from video production to music production. So we went ahead and just knocked it out. And then that was just my return. It's been over at before then, it was about 6 years before anybody heard anything from me. So it was just a return and to show that I was still alive, I'm still here, and hey, I'm back. So, they awoke that dog in me. I'm back now. You know what I mean?
Okay, well, it's a really awesome song, and I know everyone out there is getting ready to watch it and agree with me there. But before we get into that, I just want to thank you again, DJ Formula, for being on the show. Come back anytime you want to plug something new, and we'll have you back on maybe.
Hey man, I appreciate it. I'm gonna come out there to Alabama, man. Come hang out, man. We're gonna go hit the bar together, man. With some broads. That's what we're gonna do, me and you. Just me and you, man. Go get some ladies.
Sounds like a plan, man.
All right, man. You have a great one, man.
Okay, and here it is, the return, and it starts right now.
It's the big boss, Ricky Wilson, right now. Y'all checking in with Man Never and my brother Formula.
Man, it's your man, Mr. Chief, man. When I fly through Delaware, you already know who I'm banging it with, man. My man, DJ Formula, man.
You are about to witness a return like no other. It's been a long time coming, now I'm back on my job. I'm back like cook crack, it's the return of the Kettle One gangster, slick tongue wordplay. Retired for a week, but resurrected the third day. And niggas talking money got me laughing like, how they got the nerve to put beats to they capping like. I know a lot of real niggas, y'all ain't that. Y'all probably snitching for pussy with a smile. And that's fact, he's back. The wise word Kodiak, respected in the hood. I'm a legend and a throwback. R.I.P. Dom, young legend, we the army. Protected by an angel, so you haters can't harm me. VIP status, my connection is crucial. The first in the hood to do things you only could Google. Platinum parties, did that. Multi whips, did that. 100 grand in the hood, got it flipped and spent. Ha, ha, y'all niggas done did it. You always talking that shit. Real money off. Got you haters on the run now. Cause I'm back on my shit. Y'all niggas done did it. Y'all was talking that shit. Got them haters on the run now. Cause I'm back on my shit. See, I was gone for a minute, now I'm back on my BI. Tunnel vision, money, hustle, game like TI. My P stands for presence, so my presence always VI. OG, still sunning, Joe niggas like GI. Delaware raised with a worldwide swag. City to city pimping with a worldwide bag. All Star Weekend, CI double official. With big guns and bullets the size of dill pickles. Money over everything, profit over BS. Realness over buffoonery, pussy over stress. Words before guns, but guns before death. Make sure your circle is tighter, your circle goes left. Made a lot of money, but my friends stay the same. Long as I stay official, then the game don't change. Drip stay classy, the money's getting bigger. Probably the main reason your girl are fat niggas. Y'all niggas done did it. Y'all was talking that shit. Got you haters on the run now. Cause I'm back on my shit. Y'all niggas done did it. Y'all was talking that shit. Got them haters on the run now. Cause I'm back on my shit. You are about to witness a return like no other.